Hi, this is Alicia Pollock from learn.royalwise.com. And today, the troubleshooting that I would like to do is what to do when you're running payroll in QuickBooks Online, but you had it set up pointed to the wrong bank account. What happens is when you run payroll, it makes payroll checks that you can't edit. Like right here, I'm looking at the OnPoint checking account and I can see all of the paychecks that were made. And they're here because that's what was set up in QuickBooks, that this is where they should go. But if they really came out of a different checking account, you can't just delete them. Because, for example, if I click on edit and go into the transaction, all it does is take me to the paychecks themselves. And you can't actually, there's no way to delete this without really messing up the payroll run. You would actually delete the payroll run, not just this transaction. So there's another solution. So I'm going to cancel this and we're going to head back. I'm going to hold down the back button here to get back to my register. Sometimes when you're in payroll, it takes a couple tries to get back because it kind of holds onto the payroll settings. So I'm actually going to, there we go, back again. So QuickBooks is telling us that payroll came from OnPoint, but the bank feed, when I go into banking and we look at the correct checking account, you would actually see those transactions in the bank feed here. And so your inclination is to go, oh, these are paychecks, and I'll go ahead and I'll classify them as wages. I'm not sure why this keeps zooming over on me. So the, Cynthia, are you touching it?
No.
No? Okay. It keeps sliding over. So the paychecks on here, now these were already accepted, but you as a bookkeeper, your tendency is going to be to say, oh, this was this paycheck to this person, and this was this paycheck to this person. And the end result, if I go into the register for the checking account that they really came out of, is that if we go to that same date range, February 22nd, we are going to see them. Come on, baby my touch here. Okay, oh, I'm in the wrong account. No wonder I can't find it. Okay. No wonder they're not there. All right, Chase.
There we are.
There we are, okay. So here we are now in Chase checking. And this is the current payroll run since it's been fixed. And so you can see that those have the same direct deposit, uneditable paychecks. If I go up to last month's payroll, and so we're using February 22nd as our date. Here, you can see the ones that you put in. I can tell the difference because it doesn't say direct deposit. And if I click on any one of them, I actually want to use this other guy. I'm going to use James here. If I go in and I edit the check, I can see, bum, bum, bum. Come on. Cynthia, can you click on James Henley and then click on edit for me?
Sure.
Oh, okay. There it goes. Just took a while. So you can see here that this was manually added. What happens, the end result of this, you know, natural logical progression is that now your payroll has been doubled because the payroll was really run out of the payroll system, but pointed to the wrong checking account. And then you duplicated the actual checks by calling them payroll here. Does that make sense so far?
Yeah.
So what the fix is because we now have double payroll, and if you try and reconcile the account that QuickBooks thinks they came out of, you've got too many transactions. So we need to put that money back in the OnPoint checking account and still have it come out of here without having both of them say salary. So the trick is to change this category so that it goes to the OnPoint checking account. And what that will do is now this will not be counted towards wages. And I'm going to do this to like two of the employees so that we can see the net effect of it. So we'll do it to that one. Let me pick another one. We'll do Bruce. And I'll edit that one. And I'll do the same thing. Now you're still going to have to go in and do the rest of the run, but I'm going to do these two.
Okay.
So come on, computer.
Woo-hoo. I hope that's...
There we go.
I don't know why it's so slow. Okay. So instead of a payroll expense, we changed that to the on-point checking.
Okay, yep. So this goes to on-point. Checking. Okay. So as I said, you would go through and you would do all of them, but because our connection is slow, we're just going to do these two as an example. Now, when I go back and look at on-point, the money still came out of the Chase account because that's where the money came from. When I look at the payroll run from those dates, I now can see the money going in and out for these two people. So here's the 619 from payroll. I'm sorry, here's the 619 out from payroll, and here's us putting that 619 back. Here's the here's the 596 from Bruce putting it back again to offset his paycheck right here. So when you reconcile, both of these will zero each other out, so it no longer affects the balance in the erroneous bank account. The payments were still made out of the correct checking account, and the expenses were allocated properly for taxes because they still came from the original payroll. Okay, so that is how to fix payroll when it's run out of the wrong account. This is Alicia from Royalwise Solutions, and if you enjoyed today's video, please find out more at learn.royalwise.com.